A powerful windstorm sweeps across the state, knocking out power to tens of thousands. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. The high winds blew through overnight and have lasted all day. All right, take a look at this video right here from Portland, where this sign, well, it was no match for the windy conditions. And all over the state, gusts brought down tree limbs and power lines. CMP says there are currently more than 22,000 customers still in the dark tonight. The most are in Lincoln County, where more than 6,000 are still without power. Sagadahoc also hard hit tonight. The wind so strong this morning that they actually blew a metal roof right off of this business here in Old Town. Take a look at that. A nearby police officer actually prevented the roof from blowing into the middle of the street. Fortunately, no one was hurt there. And we have team coverage in our first warning weather tonight. News 8 Steve Minich live in Auburn with more on the wind damage and meteorologist Roger Griswold tracking the wind gusts from the weather center for us. But first, let's check in with Steve.
Well, Tracy, even right now, the wind continues to blow at a pretty steady clip. The difference, though, between this evening and this morning, well, a few hours ago, it was a balmy wind. Now it's a good 15 degrees colder. So we're really starting to feel that wind as these temperatures continue to drop. Now, according to Central Maine Power, at one point this morning, as many as 42,000 customers were without power. Cumberland and Kennebec counties, along with the mid-coast, were the hardest hit. This is video from Topsom, where a snapped tree fell and snapped a power line, cutting power to many homes and forcing the street to be closed down for most of the day.
I heard big booms, about 3 to 4 of them, and I didn't get up to check it. But when I got up about 8 o'clock, there was no power or anything.
It's 50, I think it was 54 degrees this morning, wasn't it? We got the high winds, but we got the warm temperature. And I went in my house and it was still 66 degrees upstairs, and my pellet stoves have been shut off for 4 hours.
While many did certainly welcome the warm weather out west in Oxford County, where a lot of rain also fell overnight, it had folks there keeping a close eye on the rivers and streams. This is the Swift River as it runs through the small town of Roxbury. A flood warning was up for most of the day. So far, however, it has not spilled over its banks. So some wild weather over the last 24 hours, but luckily it appears we have escaped without any significant serious damage. I'm Steve Minich in Auburn.